out there, and we are ready to go. Referee has the ball in his hands, and we can jump it up. It's the London Lions against the Plymouth Raiders in the BBL Championship. Penn times the jump, and the Raiders will get us underway with the opening offense. Through the hands of Penn.
Penn got it by Green.
There's Rochford to Watson, and Watson was about to fly. You just said Rochford's had a few foul issues this season. That's not a great start, foul on the first play.
No, that's not what you want to see from Rochford to begin the game. You know, he's probably their strongest force inside, so early fouls like that could hurt them later on in the game. We'll see how he fares after this.
Well, he's averaging over four fouls a game, which suggests you foul out a bit to get to that high an average. Here's Dixon going to work, and oh, he can't quite convert. Weed with the rebound, has his shot blocked. Watson in the open court. Rochford onto Watson. Sayers in the corner. Rochford now back out to Watson. Kicks it out. It's a tough 3-point shot from Penn, doesn't go.
Great job there defensively from London.
Skip past the hole, Dixon underneath, but well read by Watson. Kicks it out to Penn, he's leaked out on the break, and he lays it in. First points on the board.
Great pass from Watson, finding Penn on the break there. You know, London's got to get back and protect the paint.
Neil Watson averaging 6 assists a game. Nice lay-in underneath.
Really looking to get to the ball to Dixon early, get him going. But, you know, it's good to see. Great ball movement there from London.
Penn under pressure from Hackney's finest.
Here's Rochford. Watson, nice pass inside. Barrio can't convert, pulled off the ring by Dixon.
There's a mouse in the house
for
Will Hall. No, says, we see
you.
Kick out.
Here's Lanega off the iron with the 3-point shot. Oh, all the way through the pain. It didn't look like there was any space for him there.
Tough finish from Barrio there. Again, getting out in the break. London's really got to get back and focus on defense and transition.
Hall with the zip pass to Guid underneath.
Working on his show business. Random Penn stops.
Is Penn, and he converts.
Tip for tap right now. Early doors, quarter number one.
Robinson. Back to Dixon.
Dixon.
Nice pass from Green. Back to Dixon. Head fake. Gets his man in the air and he takes it to the hole.
Great head fake there from Dixon. Going middle. Finishing with a nice flush around the basket.
Right. Basket for basket here in the opening 3 minutes at the Copper Box. Tied at six. Rochford going to work. Strong off the glass. Rims out.
Lanega
pushing, Watson trying to pick his pocket, and Rochford just lands on Hall, and that's going to be his second personal foul.
Yeah, they're going to be looking at the bench here, subbing in Big Zach Wells. Rochford, you know, he's got to be playing more with his mind than his body. He's kind of throwing the body around a bit too much. Now he's going to go sit on the bench. We'll see if Zach Wells can hold it down for him.
Well, it's very early in the game as well to have picked up two fouls. Robinson hits the three.
Nice little inbound play to get Robinson wide open. That's what you want for Robinson. He's a knockdown shooter. Get a screen him, get him wide open.
Trying to get it to Wells. Dixon knocks it loose. Here comes Robinson. Turns the jets on, goes strong up high. Tipped in by Paul Guid. Good follow, and he still had work to do.
Penn
spins one way, back the other, dumps it off to Wells. Oh, and the former London Lion can't convert. Robinson trying to flip it out, but the Lions still have it.
Ball is hot to drop. Robinson hot to drop. Paul.
Hanega turns down the three. Gweed doesn't. Gweed rims out.
Tough miss there, but still great ball movement from London. They're looking real athletic these days.
Sayers in the corner. His triple doesn't go. Wells almost comes down with it.
Relentless Lions on the offense.
Robinson.
Robinson calls for the screen. The kick out is Lanigan's.
Lanigan has it.
Lanigan with a hesitation.
Shot clock down to six, down to Dixon. Gweed in the corner for another triple. Yes, that's good. And the Lions lead by eight.
A little bit of a defensive breakdown there. Gweed was wide open in the corner for that shot. Looks like Gavin Love wants to call the boys in and talk about it.
Well, they lost him on a couple of occasions. And that time in the corner, Gweed knocks down the three. Robinson hit one just a moment ago. And that is why the Lions lead by eight here in this ball game. And the issue perhaps is Wells not quite as mobile as Rochford. So Rochford picking up those early two fouls has caused them a little bit of an issue. I was just looking back, and Rochford has actually fouled out of seven of his last nine games, to the point that you were making earlier about the foul trouble issue. And it hurts his minutes and therefore hurts his flow if he gets into early foul trouble as he has done today.
Yeah, Rochford's a guy, you know, he plays with his heart on his sleeve. He's got a fiery personality, but, you know, you have to learn how to, you know, kind of hone into things and not realize that you can't reach for every ball or jump for every block.
Well, Merry Christmas to you all, including the cheerleaders who've come in full Santa gear as the two teams make their way back out onto the court.
Alongside Lanigan Hall and Robinson.
Joe Ikenwin into the game and playing a bit of full court pressure.
So extended defense on the Lions.
Watson gets free in the end.
Watson
to Penn, into Wells. Traveled with it, but it never quite had control of the ball, and his feet kept moving.
Bit of a fumble there with the ball. Zach's got to get his hands on that, keep the play going.
Even in the new rules, that's still a travel with this gather step or zero step legislating traveling into the game. But, ooh, it's a bit of a flop, says the referee. If Ikenwin lays that in, I think he's going to get a flop warning here at Akoya.
Tough move from Joe in the post. Real strong. That's what you want to see from your captain.
Adekoya in the corner for three off the assist from Watson. They needed that. Here's Ikenwin now from behind the arc. Oh, inside and then out for Joe Ikenwin.
Feeling it. He is feeling it right off the bench into the game. I like that. Five quick points for Joe.
And a 10-point lead for his team. Watson trying to toss it in.
By the helicopter, that's Brandon Peel.
Brandon Peel going up for it.
Direct in traffic.
Lions looking pretty dangerous here in the opening 7 minutes. They've already got 19 points on the board.
Nice,
Peel diving down the lane. Back out, Ikenwin again. Joe Ikenwin with eight quick points.
The man is hot. Give him the ball, shooting from the three. Great shot.
Adekoya for three off the back of the ring.
Seeing a lot of quick outside shots from Plymouth. I think they need to slow it down, work the ball inside out basketball to get him back into this.
Hall going to the basket, knocked by Wells. Adekoya takes it hard. He did well there, because that pass was a little far out in front of him. And he managed to not only haul it in, but still to attack the basket.
It was a great take to the basket, got the foul, gives them time to slow it down, regroup, and you know, get back on track here. Plymouth can't let the game get too far away from here. You know, big, big lead. We're still only in the first quarter.
Well, I always think at times like this, when the game's not going your way, you just got to find a way to hang on in there until your momentum will come back to you at some point. You just got to make sure that the gap that you have is not insurmountable.
100%. I mean, I'd be looking at Neil right now to slow down the tempo and really get back on track here. We're seeing, you know, a lot of threes getting jacked up. This foul going to the line, knocked down an easy two. This will help get momentum back their way. Oh.
Off the back of the rim.
An easy one.
Eisenbarger comes in for the ball. Here's Ickerman again. Here he is for another three. Oh! It goes in off the bounds.
Three for three from Big Joe. I love it.
Well, I know he's a big sci-fi fan. The Force is with him tonight.
So good. Another quick three from Plymouth here. Neil, good job to clean up that board.
A turnover by Watson, stolen by Peel. Bounce pass to Robinson to Ickerman. And the foul is called. He will go to the line.
I think Joe has got the Christmas spirit in him tonight. He is he's all over the place. Great shooting from outside. Driving it hard down the lane. Gets the foul. Let's see if he can knock these down.
Boy, he's got more already than the Raiders have. He's got 11 and a chance to go to 13 here. If you're watching our WBBL coverage earlier, Ashley Harris had a similar start, knocking in threes. And she had her team's first 13 points on that occasion, and finished up with 39. So that's the high water mark of the day on this court. Here's some way to go to catch her up. But he's doing it the right way so far with 13.
Big, big numbers from Joe early on here. Plymouth really needs to get back on track here and find a score.
Now the line puts it on the floor, loses it, but loses it because he got fouled. And the reach in there from Ickerman. It'll be a baseline ball. He got some of the ball, but he went across the wrist on that. Watson drives in. Watson with the rearrange. Lockhart up and running. Lockhart has it. They can win again. No, he didn't get the bounce. He got a friendly bounce on the last one, but not on that one. The ball belongs to the Lions. And the Lions will keep possession. Not loose and out of bounds by Penn. So it'll be a possession from the side this time.
12 seconds on the clock. They just need to keep an eye on the shot clock from this possession.
Peel drives in, tosses it up, almost went in as well. Watson pulls up for the three in transition. Oh, getting it high. Back to Peel. Eisenbarger, all on his own. Well, he's already scored 13 points and they totally lost him there.
Huge, huge quarter for Joe, you know. When a guy's hot like that, you got to find him, give him the ball, and that's what they're doing.
Offensive foul the call as Eisenbarger hits the deck.
Smart play from Eisenberger there.
Well, Joe Ickerman sits down. He's got 15 points to his name. His season average is 6.6 points per game. So he's almost tripled his season average already. In fact, that's his career average, my mistake. His career average is 6.6. He's averaging less than 4 a game this season.
Looks like he ate his Wheaties this morning.
He certainly did.
Dixon to Lockhart.
Peel at the elbow. Well, everything going in for the Lions here. 31 points, and we're still to reach the end of the first quarter.
Seeing Plymouth switch up to a zone now, trying to slow down London shooting.
Good hands from Dixon to steal it away. Out to Lockhart, thought he was going to pull up for three there. He goes inside to Dixon instead. Eisenbach, he can't give him that room. No, oh, it comes up short. He's normally a deadly three-point shooter when he's got that much space. Just a few seconds between shot and game clock here. Maybe four and a half as Watson tries to run it down. Just got to watch that heel on the halfway line. Oh, with the crossover, Neil Watson taking it to the rack.
Looking for the foul call, didn't get it.
Lockhart drives in, he does get the foul call. And they're over the limit, so it'll be two free throws even though he passed it.
That was a great move from Neil Watson down the other end. You just gotta finish when you get the contact. Smart play by Lockhart down here, got the foul. Finish out the quarter.
Watson throws it the length of the court and it is short, but what a blistering first quarter by the London Lions. 33 points at the offensive end, but equally as pleasing for their fans will be only 10 points against defensively.
Yeah, I mean, London's doing a great job of moving the ball. They're looking very unselfish. Everybody's getting touches and it's leading to good shots. On the other end, Plymouth, you know, not taking care of the ball has gotten, a couple of easy turnovers. And quick shooting from outside, I think, is limiting their offense. If I was Gavin Love, you know, I'd be telling him to slow down. Let's run some offense. Let's move the ball. Let's find our scores. You know, Neil, a couple little ticky-tack ones that didn't go in. I'd be looking to Penn. You know, their leading scorer. He's got to get the ball, put the ball in the basket.
33 points in a quarter is the best start that the Lions have had this season. The last time they got a number that big, they got 35 in April at the end of last season against Cheshire, and they went in on 35-17. They won that quarter, went on to win that one by 12. But I think the key thing here for the Lions is not to get carried away and think, well, we've done everything, the shots are going in, and sort of forget and allow the Raiders to sort of sneak back into it.
Yeah, I mean, that's one of those things when you go up early and you peak too soon, you can get a bit complacent, and then, you know, towards end of the third, fourth quarter, teams sneak back in. So right now, you know, just a strong emphasis on defense from them. Keep moving the ball, keep finding the open guys, and maybe get Joe back in there. He's hot tonight.
Well, the other way, Raiders have got to just find some way of making some shots, shooting 26% from the floor. And just one of six from the three-point line. And it's the Lions who get us underway here in the second quarter, already leading by 23.
Plymouth is sticking with a 2-3 zone here. Just got to focus on keeping the ball out of the middle.
Wade with the tough shot. That might just drop for him. No, he's batted up in the air. And Watson keeps it in bounds.
Good start for Plymouth there. That's what they need, a stop and keep chipping away at this lead.
Penn taking it to the basket. And there's a foul. Dixon was there, but I think the foul is going to be on Peel. 22, the signal.
Good start to the quarter for Plymouth. You know, they got a good stop down at the other end and now going to the line. They just need to keep chipping away, like I said, chipping away, chipping away. They've dug themselves a bit of a hole here, but, you know, the game's not over till it's over. Keep chipping away.
One other game going on in the BBL Championship, and that is the league leaders, Leicester, down in Guildford taking on the Surrey Scorchers, and the Riders currently leading 25 points to 33 in that one.
Second is good for Brandon Ben. Reed has the ball advanced. Lockhart directs it.
It was Lockhart. Peel. Dixon gets some space, drives in and lays it in. Again, just finding the gap in the lane.
Yeah, I mean, the zone's working, but you got to keep the ball out of the middle, especially when you got a guy or a matchup with Dixon and Wells. You know, Dixon, very springy, quick forward.
Eisenbarger, a little too high. That was one where he probably needed Guid to be the man there rather than Lockhart. It's just out of the reach. Andre Lockhart.
Rochford's back in the game. Let's see if he can play smart basketball here and stay out of foul trouble.
Looks for Rochford.
Right. Here he is on the pick and roll. Gets it in the lane. Nice pass from Rochford. Oh, Penn can't convert. Peel. Dixon. Cross court, but it's stolen away by Penn. Watson comes up with the loose ball. Bounces it out. Adekoya for three. Knocks it down. Hit one on the near side. Now he hits one on the far side.
Good defense down at Plymouth. Leads to good offense down at the other end. Big three. I think they needed that one.
They sure did. And Coach Carroll has just called a halt to proceedings after that one drops in. But when you get yourself in this situation, Mike, and you find yourself in a big hole early in the second quarter, do you set yourself little targets, or is it just about keep going with it?
Yeah, well, I mean, I would look at it by the quarter. So, you know, you're looking at in the next 8 minutes, can we get this back even, or can we chip 10 points off this lead? You know, you got to look at it, little micro goals here. And then that'll in turn lead to breaking down the lead throughout the whole game.
And what do you think Gavin Love would be most concerned about? Is it the 35 points that have gone in at one end, or is it his offense only managing 14 and 12?
Well, obviously, you know, with the Kim win, I think he's going to be, you know, telling the guys, like, let's not let him touch the ball anymore. But I think that they've missed a few easy baskets that they should have made. So I think he's telling them they got to finish. And then down the other end, let's keep that ball out of the middle. The ball's getting in the middle in the zone way too easily. But I think, you know, subbing Rochford in back in will help out with that.
Here we go then. Lions ball from the end. Raiders showing a bit of a press. It is a 2-2-1 zone press by the looks of it. And they drop back in to the zone defense as well. Peel at the elbow, drives in, Rochford blocks the shot. Dixon got caught on the side of the head by Penn. And he will go to the line for a couple.
Couple of digestives, I think.
Yeah, a bit of a silly foul there from Penn. Should have just kind of let him get the shot off. Always got to watch your back with these BBL refs.
Careful now.
Rims out the first.
Dixon misses the first free throw. Makes the second. Started the year in Belgium with Limburg before joining the Lions this week. Sayers inside, can't convert. Guid chases it down. Around the 3-point line it goes for London. Just not quite high enough to get over Penn. But he could only deflect it. Into the game as Sayers sits down. 8 on the shot clock.
Dixon.
Shot clock ticking down as Peel takes it. Tough one with a guy diving out at him.
Yeah, again, they just keep finding the guys in the middle. Tough shot at the end of the shot clock there.
Rochford trying to go to work. Doesn't get that to go. Peel. Eisenbarger now for three. That's way over the mark. You don't see that very often from Eisenbarger.
Yeah, traditionally a great shooter from outside. I think he got a little bit too excited on that one. Let it go too early.
He shoots over 47% for his BBL career. Great last year. Turnover there from Peel. Here's Watson. Watson gets it to the bar and takes it. Still the Raiders have it. Penn. Technical foul called. I think it's on Gavin Love. Yes, it is. He must have said something. I think he thought that they got a foul on the drive to the basket, and he was not happy about that.
Yeah. I don't know who it was. I think it was Abario got knocked off his line on the drive. They kept possession of the ball. It was a tough one. Penn looked like he was about to score there. You never want, you know, a tech right before you're about to score. Or maybe he was just telling him Merry Christmas. Who knows?
Yeah. The card's in the back for you. I'll give it to you after the game. Well, you get one shot, which...
That's more like it.
Yeah, Eisenbarger knocks down.
Checking back in. Justin Robinson taking the break. Jack Eisenbarger.
Justin Robinson checking back into the game. Let's see if he can keep these boys inspired and keep this lead.
Robinson. Oh, it's almost stolen away. It is stolen away by Penn. Takes it to the basket and lays it in.
Great hands by Penn, you know, denying on the weak side and getting out the other end. Easy basket.
The extended zone defense from the Raiders.
Still, they trail by 23, Plymouth.
Nice.
Oh, Dixon almost loses it. Gets it back at Fowler. Wow, it slip out of his hands. He's got a smile on his face. It was a long way short.
Watson
drives in, up in the air.
Oh.
And through the gap between two of his teammates and out of bounds.
Great drive there by Watson. And the jumping out of bounds. Look for the pass. He had three guys to go to. I think they all kind of got confused. And who's it going to?
Well, here comes Joe Ickenwin back into the game, who is only just behind the Raiders. He's got 15 to Plymouth 16. Can he continue that first quarter form? Here's Robinson in the corner for three. Rochford, nice dump off. Adekoya cutting to the basket.
Great pass from Rochford. He's one of those bigs where, you know, you can't lose him because he's a tough guy inside, and he's also a good passer from the post.
Gui tries another triple. Oh, the ball bounced off the ring. Adekoya wasn't expecting it. Ooh, that's going to be a foul on Hall. Didn't get there in time.
Yeah, Hall stepping in a bit too late there. Gets called for the blocking foul.
Not the worst foul to give up in that position, particularly as it's only his first.
Yeah, sometimes you have to use your fouls, you know, smartly, slow down the offense, especially when the other team's starting to get on a roll.
Stepped out of bounds.
Don't think he was too happy with himself on that one.
Well, Coach Carroll's going to call a timeout here. Side leading by 21 points, 39 points to 18. And they just need to find something here, Plymouth. They've just got to try and get some momentum. They've not really had much of a sniff of the momentum. They've slowed London down. Now, London, obviously, their points total was blown up by the quick 15 points that Ickenwin had, but 18 points in 15 minutes is not enough to win a game of basketball.
No, when you look at the stat line here, you're not seeing much scoring. You know, you've got Adekoya, with 8, and Penn with 7, and then not much else across the board. So, you know, you got to get other guys involved. I think they're playing a lot of individual basketball, but they need to do more team stuff, start executing some plays, get everybody involved, and get some other guys, get them going.
Yeah, just 3 players have scored in this game for the Raiders, and as you say, all but 2 of them have come from Penn and Adekoya. Their shooting numbers are not great. They've just got to find something to give them in this last 5 minutes some momentum going into the locker rooms.
I'm sticking with the zone here.
Robinson. Shot clock. It's going to go out. Didn't go out of bounds quick enough for them. So it'll be a 24-second violation.
I thought I saw a kick ball there, but questionable call.
I think that was what Lockhart was trying to say, and now Guid is saying, well, he kicked it, so it should reset the shot clock. And the referee's not interested in that. Watson open for 3. They need this. They don't get it.
Tough miss there, but it's in rhythm. It's a good shot from Watson. Just needs to drop.
He usually makes. Ickenwin trying to find some space, and not there. Oh, nice pass! Adekoya to the finger.
Great pass. Pumas looking great in transition.
Let's have a quick look at that last one where they're arguing. Yeah, it is a kick ball, isn't it? There's Lockhart in the corner off the back of the ring. It didn't come to anything in the end, I guess. Watson. Nice pick and roll with Rochschreder. Got caught on the elbow. Well, Justin Robinson isn't convinced. The referee is. And it will be 2 free throws.
Referee called a foul on Robinson. Substitutions for the Lions. Corey Dixon will check in.
Corey Dixon checking back into the game here, taking Lockhart out.
2 shots to come from Ombiaro.
Yeah, Plymouth's going to be looking. Who's going to be that guy for them right now? Who's going to be that spark? Who's going to, you know, lead from the front for them right now? That's what they need.
Well, we have seen this season, and indeed throughout his BBL career, Neil Watson can be the guy who goes 3-3-3-3 in quick succession. And when you're down 18, it's that sort of run that you need. He might get a steal here. Not quite. Ickenwin comes up with it. Guid is the spare man. It's not away by Adekoya, but he's done so illegally, and it will be 2 shots for the Lions.
Like we said earlier, you know, London can't get too complacent here. An 18-point lead could quickly go away. So they just need to, you know, stick with it, keep getting to the basket, keep getting to the line, keep scoring that basketball.
Guid, 8 points to his name. He's also got 5 rebounds. He's been very active out there for him. He's going to sit down. Lanega into the game.
Those free throws just bumped it up to a 20-point lead here in the first half.
Almost a steal. It is a steal. No, they've still got it somehow. Watch for it inside, and he converts. Just wouldn't give it up, but then unfortunately for him, it bounced to Rochford. to be fair, that's out of bounds. Has done a good job since he's come back in on two fouls. He's done a really good job of staying out of any trouble.
Yeah, and you know, he's that guy right now. He could be that guy. He's, you know, playing with passion, you know, screaming at the guys, trying to get the fire lit under them. So we'll see what he can do here, as long as he can stay out of foul trouble.
Oh, he's just committed his third. Just sort of chased it on a screen. And it's one of those where if the defender doesn't run into you, that's not your fault as the screener. It's the ball handler's fault. Don't go chasing it. And the referee says he stuck a leg out. And despite his protestations, it's a third personal foul.
Dixon.
Oh, good pass back to Will Hall. He looked trapped for a second there, Corey Dixon.
Great pass from Dixon, finding Hall down the middle. I believe that's Hall's first points of the game, gets him involved. Will Hall, Sheffield lad, good Sheffield lad.
He is indeed. I had this debate as to whether he actually played for Sheffield or not. He did sit on the bench, but he never came on as a youngster.
Yeah.
So technically,
I believe he was registered with the team, but
he was, yeah.
Never stepped on the court.
Never stepped on the court, so they technically, he didn't have his debut with the Sharks.
He did not, but he's one of those guys that came up through the Sharks youth system.
Here he is. Great driving player to the basket, and right on cue, scoring off the glass.
There you go. Confidence is going for him now.
45 plays, 23.
Extending the lead out a little bit.
Well, they're almost doubled up here in the first half, the Raiders. 45 plays, 23. Wells backing down. Little reach in from Dixon. Again, that's not the worst foul in the world. It's one of them. It's a bit of a gamble. You might knock it loose, and worst case scenario, the foul's on the floor. They're over the limit, so they're going to give penalty free throws.
Yeah. Not the worst foul, but not the smartest one. Reaching in on Zach Wells.
Although if he fouls a second later, it becomes an and one, because he did go on to score that.
That's right.
That's certainly what Coach Love is arguing. Why is it not an and one if it's two shots? But it's, referee did point to the floor as soon as he called it. So it's two shots because of the foul situation. Off the back of the ring for Wells. And Hall turns point guard for a second there, and then finds somebody who's done it a bit more than him. Here's Robinson for three. Up rims it, and Wells with a good rebound. Wells going to work in the low post, trying to find Adekoya in the corner.
Not a bad move from Wells. Wells there, good kick out.
Good strength as well. And pass deflected away.
9 seconds on the clock here. Let's see if they can convert.
Oh, they turn it over. Robinson. Takes it hard. Tipped. Oh, not quite in by Dixon. Somehow London don't come up with a score there. Here's Watson back to Penn. Penn, finger roll is short. He wants a foul, he's not getting it.
Hall has it. Great hustle back. Hall and Lanigan.
Well, both teams probably should have scored there. That's going to be a foul for a forearm, I think, from Will Hall.
Will Hall looks a bit flustered by that call. Both teams missing easy baskets in transition there. The ball doesn't seem to want to go in the basket.
Oh, it's just hesitated for a second because they did get a flop warning earlier on the Raiders. And referee's signal wasn't immediate, so I was wondering whether he was going to go for a technical, but he did call a forearm. Penn. Watson in the corner. Finds a little space to that trusty little floater, but it doesn't go for it.
Penn has
Neil Watson yet to score in the game. Penn almost banks in a three. Well, I build up the point guard play, and it's 3 points to Robinson, none to Watson, and a combined one of 11. So good spot by me there. There's Will Hall with the simplest of putbacks.
47 plays 24.
No defense from Plymouth on that last possession.
Time ticking down here in the first half. Penn shot off the mark. Ball is loose, saved. And that will do it. An excellent first half for the London Lions. Joe Hickenwin giving them all the momentum in the first half, and they've ridden that all the way through to halftime with a comfortable lead.
Yeah, I mean, 23-point lead here going into half. Plymouth dug themselves quite a hole here. It's important for them to keep their heads up, stay positive, and realize that, you know, they can come back from this, but it's just going to take a lot of work.
Well, they really got things going early on. The three-point shots were dropping, and they got to the basket well. Some good second-chance opportunities, but really it was when Guid hit the three, and then Hickenwin started hitting threes and doing a bit of everything, that they gained all of that first quarter momentum on their way to 33 points in that opening 10 minutes.
Oh, yeah. Look at, like, the outside shooting from them has been phenomenal. Good ball movement. All these things are leading to momentum, and it's tough to stop a team when, you know, everything's going in for them.
Well, you would say, looking at the scoreboard, 47 is not the end of the world. It's a few points more than you would like to give up in a half, but it's not the end of the world. The problem for Plymouth is the 24 points that they've scored.
Yeah, they're not putting the ball in the basket enough, and, you know, you look at a guy like Neil Watson, and, you know, no points on his scoreboard right now. So I think they're going to be looking to Neil to really get charged up this second half and really get to the basket.
Well, we're at the half here at the Copper Box. It's the London Lions 47, the Plymouth Raiders 24. Let's have a look back at the BBL plays of the week.
We'll be right back.
confidence. Rochford's just got to be smart while he's out there, and then maybe they got to find him inside a little bit and get everybody involved. Move that ball around, execute. I haven't seen much offense from Plymouth yet.
Well, one other game going on they started a bit ahead of us, so they're midway through the third quarter. It's the Scorchers 49, the Riders 65. I'm pretty sure some expert called that a home win earlier on, but there you go. Can't get them all.
I won't let them know who.
No. Mario driving in, rebound Dixon. Kicked out long to Hall. And it will be an end line ball for the Raiders.
Bit of a looping pass there going out of bounds.
Baseline. Lanagar holds the play. There's Robinson.
Dixon, a lot of space. It's eventually filled, but too late. Again, just good ball movement from the Lions, finding the open gap.
That's it. And to say, you know, this is his first game and he only probably got here midweek, you know, he's doing all right so far, picking up all the offensive plays, doing pretty good on defense, and then, you know, putting the ball in the basket on the inside, which is what they wanted from him.
Crosses it out to
Ubiaro.
He rises up.
Shot is off the mark. Well, they got in each other's way, and Rochford profited.
Rochford answering. Big for big baskets there.
Good steal. Penn running it back. Drives in. Lanega hits the deck. Gets helped up, but referee's just not interested. I don't know if he's in the no charge. I can't tell from that angle. And a turnover at the same time.
I think that was a good no call from the refs there. He didn't really have his feet set, kind of looking for the call. But how about this start here from Plymouth? You know, this is the start that they needed in this half. Like, still a huge lead, but you got to chip away at it, right? And good start, two big baskets to start the half, and now they hold on to possession for maybe a third basket here.
Well, it's one of those things that you're a long way back, but if you can just, as you say, chip away with it at it and somehow get it into single figures. Here's Rochford spinning baseline. He'll go to the line for a bonus. And we said they needed to get him going and get Watson going. Here's Watson feeding him and Rochford for the three-point play.
And you can see him now. He's barking at his guys. He's getting everybody going. That's what you need from Rochford, you know. High-intensity, passionate player. He's the guy who could help turn this game around for them.
And he converts the three-point play. It's down to 18.
Paul. Robinson
from behind the arc for three. And there you go. Those 3 points wiped off straight away by Justin Robinson. Justin Robinson, I was looking at his shooting numbers this week. And some of the more advanced metrics. Unbelievable numbers from point guard position, shoot the ball so well. He actually leads the league in efficiency rating, which is almost impossible to do. Normally it's big guys like you who lead those categories because of the rebounds and the points scored.
Yeah, well, that's what I was going to say. You know, when you look at Justin Robinson, that's the first word that comes to mind is efficient. You know, he doesn't make many mistakes, not a lot of turnovers, and he can score.
Kind of lets the scoring come to him as well, doesn't it? It's not the first thing he thinks of, but he can certainly hurt you.
Definitely, and I think that's what we're seeing from this London team is he doesn't make bad decisions, and he's not a selfish player, so he's willing to move the ball around, and that gets other guys involved.
Watson.
Good hands from Robinson to knock it loose. And it will be out of bounds. And they will keep possession. Unsportsmanlike foul called on Joe Aikenwin. I didn't see what he did there, but. So it'll be two shots in possession. Let's see if we can see it. It's coming around the screen. He's grabbed hold of him. I guess it's under the new rule. It's no real play at the ball. Obviously, the ball's not even there.
Yeah, a bit of a harsh call there, but, you know, off the ball fouls, you know, you gotta, can't be holding guys. You got to keep your hands to yourself. London's got to be smart here. You know, like I said, a team like Plymouth with, you know, a lot of dangerous outside shooters can quickly turn something like this around and get themselves back in the game, or at least within, you know, within shooting distance.
There was a game earlier this season, I think it was Leeds at home, where I remember seeing Watson just go literally almost four plays in a row, 3-3-3-3, and suddenly what had been a slender Leeds lead was a big deficit for them. Well, if he did something like that now, they'd be right back into the game. He has that in his locker. Adekoya as well has hit some threes. Taking it inside, and they come up with it through Laniger. He's in trouble here, trapped on the sideline. Somebody in the front row got a close-up view.
Yeah, a little bit of a scrappy play there. Hopefully Justin Robinson can help get this back into their hands. Plymouth sitting back in the zone still. Got to make sure they keep that ball out of the middle.
Here's Will Hall throwing the behind-the-back pass, but it gets all the way out to Watson to the spin. Counted for Neil Watson. He goes to the line for the bonus. Well, Neil Watson, who hadn't scored up until this point, threw the contact and a chance to make it three from the line.
Put him in the blender there with the spin. Great move from Watson, and, you know, like we said, he's the guy, he's one of those guys on the team that needs to, you know, break the ice, get on that scoreboard, and really help turn this around for Plymouth.
Well, he doesn't convert the three-point play. Dixon on the trail, top of the key, nice shot.
And that's Corey Dixon's shot. You know, he's great mid-range player. I remember when he used to play for Plymouth and having to D up on him. Once he gets that 15, 18-foot range, he's pretty deadly.
And it's pretty hard to pick him up on a play like that where he's coming on the trail. And
100%. And, you know, he's springy and he's 6'8", so that ball is getting released at a really high spot, so it's hard to block.
That will be a traveling violation as Will Hall stumbled through the lane.
Will's got to kind of slow down here. He got a bit sped up on the last two times down the floor. A couple turnovers. He'll go sit down, have some time to think about it.
Watson. Watson. Inside now to Rotterdam with the spin again on the baseline. Second time he's made that move. This time he'll go to the line for two.
Yeah, great spin to the baseline. That's a tough move to guard. Tough call there. I don't know if that was a huge foul from Dixon, but he'll take it and go to the line.
First one rims out. Shoots about two out of three in his BBL career, about a 65% shooter from this distance. And he makes that and takes his tally tonight to two out of three.
Well, I can remember when he used to play for Cheshire, and he used to shoot bank shot free throws off the backboard.
Well, they don't draw pitches, they all count.
And so he switched up the form, though.
Robinson. Dixon. Back to Robinson. Little change of pace. Laniger inside to Dixon. Little tough fall away. Didn't have enough on it. Tomcic. Oh, through the hands of Watson and out of bounds. Checking in, 13th turnover of the game for the Raiders. Both teams coughed it up 13 times, which is a little too many really at this stage of a ball game.
Yeah, I would say, you know, we always at the Sharks aim for 13 for the game, so they already have that, you know, just after half. That's quite a few turnovers.
Raiders average just shy of 13. London average 12 as Robinson hits another three. And it looked like they were getting a bit of momentum a moment or two ago, Plymouth, but it seems to be disappearing away from them.
Robinson, Mr. Efficient.
Rocha takes it in. Oh, he misses the lay-in. I don't know if he was expecting the foul. Here's Peel at the other end. He doesn't miss. Penn with it up and under. But they can't go basket for basket here. They need a
59-38. Yeah, one. That's the problem. You know, you go down 20 points in the first half. Second half, you're doing great. You know, you're keeping up. But, you know, you have that 20 points to dig yourself out of.
Long two for Jack Eisenberger. Just towing the line on that one. Adekoya for triple. Robinson, great outlet pass to Peel. He will convert, but what about the assist from Justin Robinson, the length of the court?
Great court vision there, you know. Almost a full court pass there to Peel. Peel doing a great job breaking out and getting down in transition.
Well, a timeout called, and suddenly the lead is back up to 25 points for the Lions, and Raiders just not doing enough defensively in the last couple of minutes, having started the quarter with a bit of momentum.
Yeah, I mean, we saw that spark from them at the beginning of the quarter. They got to the line. Neil Watson was getting involved, but you know, a couple easy baskets in transition, and then a quick 3-point shot down on the other end, and a miss. You know, quickly deflates your team. I think, like I said earlier, you got to stick with the game plan and keep running offense, keep moving the ball, get everybody involved, and eventually that ball start going in.
Well, they're underway in the fourth quarter in Guildford, where Surrey Scorchers trail the Leicester Riders 62-79. They've just started the. There we go. In fact, they're ahead. Look at that. They're ahead of me in the graphics. It's 65-69. The Scorchers have just. Oh, good block from Peel.
Get out of my kitchen.
So Leicester look like they're on course for a 4-point lead at the top of the table going into Christmas. The turkey will taste good after that. Oh, that one bobbles out. Robinson gets the rebound. Well, Robinson falling out of bounds, and that's one of them where I think the referee didn't really want to call a foul on the bum, but because he was ended up on the ground, he kind of had to.
Yeah, I mean, Robinson a little bit off balance there, but he saw the bump by Penn.
Robinson. Dixon inside, that's another good pass.
Big buckets by Dixon, you know. First night back in the BBL, and he's already in double figures. Great start from Dixon. Oh, another full court pass here.
Oh, Peel did well there to run back. As Rochford took off. Bump foul there on Watson. That won't count. Good shot from Watson.
Couple tough calls. Back to back here for Plymouth Raiders. It's always tough to, you know, get yourself going, get the momentum back when that whistle keeps blowing.
Peel, Eisenbach. Has it ripped away? Adekoya, as Thompson's with him, might not need him. Oh, Robinson did enough. Cross-court pass again for Robinson. Blocked by Penn. Adekoya, that's a hard foul. It's an unsportsmanlike foul. on Justin Robinson. There's the block at the other end. And this is one of them where it's the follow through rather than the initial one.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you have five fouls to give, and sometimes you want to give them, but you have to watch out when you're hacking down like that. Obviously, that was a little bit too much. Gets the unsportsmanlike.
You know, in my day, if you didn't foul like that, you'd have been benched. The coach would have pulled you out. No layup rule sort of thing.
Hey, man, no blood, no foul. Come on. I'm from the old school.
Yeah, indeed.
What's up with these new rules here?
But under the definition, it is an unsportsmanlike, so two shots in possession. Well, they need something, don't they? So they get a couple of free throws, and maybe a score here.
A couple of free throws cuts it to 25, but that's that's still quite
a lot,
quite a mountain to climb there.
The other thing is 25 points when you've got 24 and a half and 14 in the third quarter is out of character with the rest of the game. Matthews for three doesn't go. Robinson knocks down the three.
Another great shot from Robinson right at the top. Always very cool, calm, and collective, Justin Robinson.
He's pulling the strings here in the third quarter. Hitting shots, finding teammates.
Yeah, very impressed with his court vision and you know, making some very long passes down the court. Finding Brandon Peel on quite a few occasions.
Watson knocks down a three.
Answer.
Yeah. His first triple of the game.
Good answer from Watson. That's what we need. Watson's the type of guy that can take, you know, one, two dribbles over half and pop that the ball up and get it in. If he gets going, could change this game around.
Eisenbarger along the baseline. Out to Lockhart. Rebound comes all the way out to the free throw. Oh, good pass, Dixon! And Peel flushes it.
Great pass from Dixon there off the offensive rebound. You know, Plymouth here kind of getting lost and losing the guys off the offensive rebound. Watson.
Zach Wells. Travel. He caught the ball and established his feet and then took the gather step that they allow them. You just watch. He has the ball, both feet are stationary, and then he moves them.
Justin Robinson sits down. Tremendous. Checks in.
Well, I'm sure if he watches the replay that we've just seen, Zach Wells might not be arguing that one. Eisenbarger in the corner for three. That's his spot.
Woo! Great three from Eisenbarger. He hit a long two from there earlier in the game. They got screened in on the zone there. They can't leave a guy like that open, especially from his sweet spot.
9 three-pointers now from the Lions, shooting over 40% from that distance. Penn to try and reply with the corner three. Lanigan. Lions already up 30. Eisenbarger's going to go from deep. Knocks it down! Back-to-back triples!
Feeling it. Eisenbarger catching fire here in the third quarter.
Penn back-to-back misses from the corner for him. Eisenbarger wants it again. Hole. Peel. Travel.
Feet got a little bit too quick under them there and got called for the travel. Slows down their momentum, but what a series of plays there from the London Lions. Almost the exact same play on the other end with the missed threes in the corner from Penn. You know, Plymouth's got to find a way right now to, you know, settle down and grind out some good offense. They got to get that ball in the basket.
Well, the shot clock and game clock are almost identical. There's about a half second between them. The Raiders can tick it all the way down, and it's a foul from Hall as Watson drives in.
Good take from Watson there. You know, that's what they need. Get a foul call. Get something going your way. Get the momentum going your way.
Will Hall always has the face of innocence afterwards.
Great energy here from the London Lions fans, really getting into the game.
Well, plenty of festive cheer. The team has been excellent from opening tip to now at the end of the third quarter.
Second is good. Lanigan on the run. Lockhart.
Oh, good follow. Peel tips it home.
Right at the buzzer. Beautiful play by Peel there. Sticking with it. Offensive rebound. Nice tipping. Great energy from the London Lions here.
Well, they had 33 in the first quarter, and they've got 31 here in the third, and they are over the hill and far away. It's the London Lions 78, the Plymouth Raiders 45 here at the end of the third quarter. And the three-point shooting just really blitzed them away in that last quarter. They suddenly started knocking them down. Eisenbarger hit a couple, Robinson as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of the live and die by the three story, where London's living by the three, and Plymouth, you know, missing quite a few three-point shots that quarter, so they're dying. But I think Plymouth's just got to find a way, you know. You got to get the ball in the basket. Obviously, they're not doing that. 45 points in three quarters here. You know, two guys in double figures. Where's that third and fourth guy? Who are those guys going to be for them? Unfortunately, you know, early foul trouble from Rochford's kept him out of the game for a lot. He could have been a bit of a game changer for him. Let's see. You know, looks like Gavin Love's gone, switching up the lineup here. Go playing a few of the bench guys, a few of the younger guys. Maybe he can get some more, you know, spark off the bench here, some more energy from some of his non-role players.
Well, the three-point shooting numbers on the game, 10 of 21, the Lions, for 47%, which is excellent. And at the other end of the floor, 3 of 17 for only 17%. So that's 21 points differential and only 4 shots taken difference.
Exactly. You know, if some of those threes drop for Plymouth, it might be a different story. But like I said, live and die by the three, and tonight it looks like they're dying.
Lockhart calls it. Lockhart finds hole.
His eyes are barking for another three. That one doesn't go.
Sayers.
Ball comes down to Peel.
Lockhart
takes it in.
No contact on that one.
Sayers. You have a line in now to Matthew for the triple. He knocks it down. Oh, nice pass. Oh, big block from Zach Wells, though.
Great block from Zach there.
Wells. Matthews. Trapped in the corner. Overthrows it. Sayer trying to keep it in bounds.
I don't know who Matthew saw on that one.
Somebody in the front row, I think. That's a super pass, but what a block that is from Zach Wells. Continue to fire from long range, London.
Great shooting from London tonight. Racking up threes all across the board.
Matthews with a hesitation.
Kick ball.
Football from Eisenbarger.
Sideline possession to the Raiders. triple. Wells almost kept it alive. Update from the other game. 3 minutes to go. The Scorchers back in that one. They're trailing by only seven.
Let's go, Scorchers.
Yeah, 75-82. That would be a good result for you guys if Leicester... Good result for everybody else in the league, to be honest with you, if Leicester were to take a loss.
100%. Open it up a little bit, make things a little bit more interesting.
But still some work for Surrey to do, trailing by seven. Anagha with the pull-up three in transition. Rebound.
Both teams going a little bit run and gun here in the beginning of the fourth quarter. It's interesting to see that they're both kind of playing with a little bit of a B lineup here.
Oh, Wells sneaks through. Didn't look like there was a gap, but Zach Wells found one. And he'll go to the line for a bonus free throw as well.
There you go, big fella. The big seven-footer doing work in the post. They need to see more of that from him.
Makes the three-point play. Lockhart drives down, tosses one up high. And the lead goes back to 32.
Great little crossover and drive down the lane from Lockhart. Push at the left.
Traveling violation called against Wells on that occasion. Lockhart chased away. Comes to Hall. Lanega dumps it off to Hall. Good pass. Wells with the rebound.
Nice. Great take from Costello here. Finishing on the weak side of the basket.
Chasing out on the line, says the referee of the missed Lockhart shot.
London really breaking this game open with a 30-point lead. It looks like both coaches are kind of letting their guys go, getting some of their bench players some minutes, get some experience out there, getting a little bit choppy out there, a little bit run and gun. But that's what happens when you go down so big in the first half.
Well, that's the thing, isn't it? When it's a 30-point game, it's unsurprising that both teams get a little loose and just up and down. And as you say, the Raiders with four of their starting five on the bench. Sayers did start the game. He's only played 10 minutes. Is the only one who is still on the court. Now James is into the game and nobody sees the shot clock. And Lanega is the only starting five. Oh, sorry, Hall started as well, didn't he? So there's two of them out there for the Lions. You have a line in for three. He stared it down, didn't he? After that one left his hand.
Yeah, he's a guy they brought in, you know, over the summer, and I was looking for him to be a little bit more aggressive tonight.
Here's James. Got some space for three.
Let it fly, young fella.
Yeah,
let it fly.
Minutes, particularly with 5 minutes to go and you're out there, let it go. He's only played a couple of minutes so far this season. Foul is called Lanega chasing that out. And Dylan Costello will go to the free throw line. A minute and 20 seconds to go in Guildford. It's still a 6-point Leicester lead, 78-84. I seem to remember some games in recent years where Leicester have scrambled out against Surrey down at Guildford with some late trees. I remember this game, I think Drew Sullivan stole a ball and scored virtually on the buzzer. Might have been 2 years ago rather than last year.
Yeah, Surrey always seems to play well down there at the sports arena down there. We played them a few weeks down there. And we
scrambled
almost,
one away.
We did.
As well.
We scrambled right towards the end. They got good fans, good atmosphere, and you know, guys always seem to play well at home.
Marl Roberts into the game for the first time tonight. He too has only had 4 minutes of action this season. He's going to get more than that tonight. And here he is. Oh, and he leaves Wells on the floor.
Go on, big fella, put it in.
And nothing they like more, the home fans, than to see the guys who don't get many minutes out there and scoring. Wells going back to the running hook. James, straight down, going north-south, and he finger rolls it in. Jonathan James.
Great to see these young guys getting in the game, given an opportunity, get some experience, build up their confidence.
Sayers is denied, Wells inside.
James has it. Feeling it.
Here's James again at the elbow trying to knock it down. Let's have a look back. I think that's his James's first points of his BBL career as well. As Peel jams it down on the break.
Great athletic move to the basket at the end there.
Well, they're thoroughly enjoying themselves here, the Lions fans now. Gets caught on the shot.
Rescued on the drive.
And he will take a couple.
Peel having a great game for them tonight, 14 points, most of them in transition. He's kind of one of those X-factor guys for the Lions, you know. He can be very sneaky, sneak up on you in double figures.
Very effective as well with his 6 of 8 for his shooting. And actually, I would think plus minus is a bit of a weird stat because it's a team number against an individual, but he's got the highest. They're up 23 with him on the court. James, I thought the three was going up, but not this occasion. Shot clock getting low. Laniger running out of trouble. James, he threw it up, but he didn't have time. It was a shot clock violation first. I don't think it's going to be, Mike. Leicester leading by 8 with 48 seconds to go. Although Surrey do have the ball on that. Still not beyond the realms of possibility, but unlikely from here.
Yeah, highly unlikely, but we won't know until the final buzzer. But, you know, Leicester done a great job of being consistent this season.
Well, they went in tonight's game 10-1, Leicester. They've only ever been 10-1 in the top flight 3 times in the club's 50-year history. They won the league on each 3 occasions. So good omens for them, and they look like they might be 11-1 by the end of the night as well.
Yeah, and when you have a team, for example, that, you know, they played London a week or two ago and squeezed out a 1-point win. When you have a team that can, you know, get those wins, those close ones, That's going to be something special for your team.
That's a legal block. On the line and thrown it out of bounds. Just at the top of the apex there.
Didn't know he could get up that high.
Eisenbach with the rearrange, and this time Roberts converts. Well, we're inside the final 2 minutes, but truth be told, this one's been over for a long while. It's a question of whether the Lions can get three figures on the board. Fans always love to see the century up. Doesn't really mean anything.
Oh, nice pass.
Nice pass to Peel! Flushes it down! Woo! Here he is. He's got space. Costello came to help. He just ended up in a post.
Good shot, my son. Plenty in the tank.
Costello taking it back in. Gordon knocks it down.
Steve Gordon with the jumper, former Shark.
There we go. You're Shark spotting tonight, aren't you, Mike?
That's it. I've been around too long. I know everybody.
yeah.
Oh, nice call from James. Kick out Eisenbacher.
Eisenbacher.
Turns the corner left.
That's a Laniger for another three. Not quite.
Off the hands of Peel. Costello brings it up.
Matthews. Good pass. You know,
the
line
pass.
Lows it home.
Ticket, we are
it's almost finished here. It has finished in Guildford, where the Leicester Riders have opened up a four-point. Oh, good block from Wells. A four-point lead at the top of the BBL Championship table this Christmas. They've beaten the Surrey Scorchers 78 points to 88. Here's Peel. Up of the key, doesn't go. The Lions are about to move to 7-4 and shift up behind Mike and his Sharks in fourth place. Sharks 7-3, so they will stay ahead on games played in third. And you've got a big one coming up in a couple of weeks against Newcastle, haven't you?
We definitely do. Well, in 1 week, 1 week today on the 29th, Newcastle up in Sheffield. Big game for us. We saw them probably about 3 weeks ago at their place. And they went up early. We were able to bring it back within seven at the end, but didn't quite have enough. So.
James, with the little Eurostep to the basket, will lay it off to round off a great night for the London Lions. They came out and just dominated it from start to finish. And really, Joe Ikenwin set it all up with that 15-point explosion in the first quarter, and Plymouth never recovered.
Yeah, I mean, like we said before, I think it was a tale of, you know, you live and die by the three. Those early threes and Joe's energy off the bench really got London going early. Plymouth staggered from the beginning, foul trouble, not missing easy shots, and they were never able to recover.
And they got good performances from elsewhere. Justin Robinson, particularly in the third quarter, really dominant performance from him. Laniger with 10 assists, 7 rebounds, almost a double-double. Really, their three-point shooting was the key for the Lions, particularly in the second half. They ended up 11 three-pointers at 42%. It's tough to deal with the team when they're knocking down threes like that.
100%. You know, you look at the stats. You got four guys in double figures, and one of them with 9 points. So when you can get, you know, 3, 4, 5 of your starters up in the over double figures, you're going to be a tough team to stop. And it shows how good of a team you are, working the ball around, being unselfish. You know, that's going to help your momentum and help you close out games.
Yeah, everybody on the score sheet for the Lions. And as you say, the top scorer only had 16 points. You get 95 points and your leading scorer says at 16, that says good things about your team. And also defensively is a nightmare to guard against. It's almost easier if you've got one guy with 30.
Yeah, exactly. It just makes them tough to stop because you've got guys scoring from all over the place. And it was great to see, you know, guys like Eisenberger hitting big shots, and obviously Joe Kimwin hitting big shots. Those are guys that usually, you know, don't have big nights for them. So when they do, it makes it that much sweeter.
Big dunk from Peel, who played really well at the end. Here's the league table then as it will stand on Christmas Day. The Leicester Riders 4 points clear of Newcastle, who are 4 points clear of Mike's Sheffield, but Sheffield with two games in hand. The loss column is the key here. The Eagles and the Sharks both on three, and you can see the Lions now rising up into the top four with a seventh victory, and the Raiders still struggling down in 10th with four wins from their 13 games. That's how the table will be for Christmas, when you can join us on the other side of Christmas as we've got more